Hi, welcome back to OD YouTube channel. Today it is the 12th December and we are opening the door number 12 from the Diamine Inkvent calendar, the red edition. And the door, window, whatever, number 12 is here, down there next to the 4 that is already empty because I'm keeping my inks in other place. So let's open this and see what we have here. We have something called Stargazer. These new bottles are much easier to take out of the calendar than the ones from the 2019 edition. So this is the Stargazer, which is looks to be like a very dark blue, I'm not sure, and this is a shimmer and sheen, so some shimmer should be expected here, and it looks to be like a nice blue shimmer, I think you can see it, and that's how we are going to see now, is how it performs on paper, not on the bottle. So, I'll be right back. So, let's just see how this nice shimmering ink, I'm saying nice, but I'm not sure, but I guess it will be a nice one, will show on paper. I say nice because many times I think Diamine is really good at making these blue shimmering and sheen inks. At least, I don't love blue inks, but inks in the Inkvent calendar of 2019, they were quite amazing, the blue ones with shimmer and sheen, so we will see how these behave. So, three drops of ink, the big Victorinox knife, and again, let's kind of spread the butter on top of the bread. That, at least that's what I think of when I do this. So, here you see how it looks. Let's wait for it to dry and I will be back for the rest of the review. So, welcome to the last part of the review. We have here the Stargazer ink and shimmer and sheen. And did we get that? Let's see how it looks. Where is that? It's here. So this is the swatch. It dried quite nicely, I would say. We have a very dark blue with clearly a red sheen and maybe a greenish turquoise. I would call it turquoise shimmer. So this ink is really interesting. Let me put it here. When I try to show it next to other inks that I have with same kind of blue, I don't have many, because I don't have many blue inks, I would go for this one, the Caveco Midnight Blue, and it's not really that amazing. You don't see that much similarity between both inks. Both are dark inks. Now let me show you the ink, the blue inks with shimmer from the 2021 Inkvent calendar. And there were two inks, and one was the Storm, which was very nice from 2 days ago, a dusty blue ink with kind of a very dark sheen there, maybe a black sheen in the place where it is really concentrated, and then a silver shimmer, but the blue is not the same at all. And then we have the Tempest, which was a very interesting one, with gold blue, dusty blue with gold shimmer. So this is really also a different color. But if we go to last year's ink, We have the Jack, last year, no, 2019, because last year there wasn't any Inkvent calendar. Actually, last year there was nothing. A very stupid year. We have this blue ink with red sheen and blue glitter. So this will be kind of similar because the sheen is similar, also red, but the shimmer color is different and the shade of blue is also different. Let me pick them up and show them to you. So the same kind of sheen, but different shimmer and different base color. And there was the ink for the last day, which was Happy Holidays, and that would be the most similar. And let me show them, because this one has that kind of green shimmer and red sheen, like this. But which are the differences? I would say that this ink kind of shares a very similar kind of blue as Jack Frost. So, but different shimmer. This one shares, I would say, the same sheen, the same shimmer as the Stargazer, but with a different blue. So, this will be more impressive because the contrast is higher, I would say, with a very bright blue and this shimmer. This one has a darker blue, but I would say they are the same properties with a different color. If you ask me, I find this one a little nicer because it's darker and I prefer it that way. But these two inks are very similar, Happy Holidays and the Stargazer, although they have different base colors. This is a very dusty kind of blue-black, and that is a bright royal blue. Now, for the swatch, the chromatography, we have a very dark part here, so we will guess there is some water resistance, and then the ink washes up, but not completely. So I would say there are different water resistance throughout the ink, and then finally we have some green and blue at the end. Let me show it on the three papers that... No, before that, sorry. Let me show you the inks that the pens that I showed for... Sorry, the pens that I chose for this video. And I chose two pens, again. And I chose a Jinhao Centennial, again. I chose a Jinhao Centennial before, but it was that koi finish with the Food and Eve, because it would give us a very interesting line variation for showing the properties of the ink. This one is just a Jinhao nib with this is a medium nib, and it is kind of a regular, not the Fuden nib. It is quite wet on this Jinhao Centennial. So the same pen, different nib, different color, but overall the same pen as before. And again, I chose last, like yesterday, a pen that I used before on this series of videos. The same explanation. I don't have many broad or double broad nibs, so if the pen is now empty, I try to reuse it for another video because I need them for this matter, but I don't really enjoy them much for my daily writing. So I have this Faber-Castell Basic in chrome. Now I can put them away and let me show you the writing samples. We have the Moleskine paper, the Oxford Optic paper, and the Navigator copy paper. Let's start with the Moleskine. On the Moleskine we can see a little bit of sheen, which is very rare to see on a Moleskine paper, and we can see the shimmer clearly, and we can see the shimmer in the writing sample, and we can see even the sheen, which is very rare again. When we look at this writing sample, we can see the Faber-Castell basic is not very good at showing the shimmer, but it can show the sheen to a point it doesn't look that much blue, it shows much darker, but you can clearly see much shimmer with the Jin Hao writing sample. Now you can see here the Jin Hao again, and there is an angle where we can see the shimmer, and with the Faber-Castell we don't see the shimmer that much. So this is how it looks. On the other side, yes, this bleeds through a little bit, but this is Moleskine paper, is not a very good one. We go for the Oxford Optic paper, which is a paper that is very good showing sheen, and you can see there, you can see the shimmer, not as much shimmer as on the Moleskine. I did this with the Jin Hao pen, this kind of swatch. Let me grab now the Navigator paper. So you can see more shimmer. You can see shimmer here on Navigator, but you can see more shimmer with the Moleskine and the copy paper, because they will absorb more the ink into the fibers and there will be more shimmer on the surface. This one doesn't absorb that water, the ink that much, so the shimmer, the sheen is much more visible and the shimmer not so much. So you can see it looks almost like a red, a black ink with a red sheen, and it's very visible there. Now, let me continue with this Oxford Optic paper. We can see again the shimmer on the Jin Hao, but it is more at the beginning when we start writing, and then it seems that the shimmer is not as strong as the flow goes on, but you can still see, like there, some shimmer. I can see it there, but with the Faber-Castell, not that much, and it just looks a very dark ink. On the other side, there is no bleed through, just a little bit here where the words, where I messed a little bit the words. And then let's go for the Navigator paper. We can see shimmer there and very hard to see with the Faber-Castell. I would say the shimmer is not as visible in this paper as it is on the Moleskine, and the sheen also not as visible as in the Oxford, and there is bleed through. Now let's go for the Rhodia paper, which is the same paper where I made the swatch, and we have here, let me try to catch some shimmer. It's not that easy to get with the lighting. I don't see much shimmer on this paper, but I think Rhodia paper is not the best to show the shimmer, not also the best to show the sheen, so I don't see much. It just seems like a very dark blue. Maybe on camera you'll see it better. For sure there is a little bit of shimmer. I can see it now, but not that much. When I make this smear test to see how it dries, you can see in the place where I smeared and there is more ink, there is definitely a little bit of red sheen, but not that much. Usually the inks that sheen take more time to dry, and this will take around 1 minute and a half to be completely dry. So it's not the best to flip pages over or to go back and write and smear your hand over the ink. But about water resistance, I dropped a few drops of water, I left them there for a few minutes, and then I dried with a paper towel, and you can see some of the ink was lifted out, but you can still see what is written quite clearly. So there is some water resistance in this ink, which may be nice if you want. I would say this ink can be used as a work an ink that you can use at work, although it has some shimmer. It will depend on the paper you use. It may not be that on your face, and you'll keep your writing if an accident happens. So let's end the video with the phrase, the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. And the same with the Faber-Castell. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. And let me raise the paper, and it's not dried, and we just see a very, very dark blue ink, almost black, and I can see a little bit of shimmer in both inks. But again, the pens are in both inks, no, in both writing samples. But again, these pens were now unused, and I think then when we start writing, there is a higher amount of shimmering particles on the nib that will show on the writing sample more than on the continuation of the writing, as we saw on the longer writing sessions. It tends to be less and less visible. So I think this will work well. This pen, I think, is quite good to show the shimmer and the sheen in the write paper. If you want a balance between both, I would say that this Oxford paper is good with this pen, not as good with the broad. So again, like yesterday, it is not mandatory that a broader nib is better to show the shimmer. What we need is a high flowing pen, so a very wet pen. So this is all for today, and I hope to see you tomorrow. And we are almost at the half of the calendar. So, bye.